Dear Goenkans, this is in reference to the second chapter edition given on your math side book. The objective of this topic is to make you able to solve and understand a word problem and write a statement defining that problem. Dear Goenkans, our today's topic is word problems. What are word problems and how to solve a word problem? We shall learn all this in our today's topic. Word problems are based on real-life situations, and we solve them by writing a statement and setting up the mathematical equation based on the information provided in the problem. We shall learn this with the help of an example. Consider a given word problem. Government allotted 20,435 houses in city A, 63,500 houses in city B, and 7,799 houses in city C. Find the total number of houses the government allotted in all. In order to solve a given word problem, we should first see what information it's providing us. Clearly, the first information is 20,435 houses allotted in city A. The second information is 63,500 houses allotted in city B. And the third information is 7,799 houses allotted in city C. Now, we shall write a statement for each of the information that is provided to us in the word problem. In the solution, we'll write the first statement for the first information. Number of houses allotted in city A, which is equal to 20,435, and place the digits in the columns correctly. For the second information, we'll write the statement. Number of houses allotted in city B, which is equal to 63,500, and we'll also place the digits in the columns correctly. For the third information, we'll write the statement number of houses allotted in city C, which is equal to 7,799, and place them in the columns correctly. Now, in the word problem, we can see that we have to find the total number of houses, the word total. We already know the answer of an addition operation is called as sum or total. Therefore, we have to add all the numbers together and their sum is the total, which will give us the total number of houses that are allotted by the government. So we'll add them and their sum is equal to 91,734. Therefore, the total number of houses allotted by the government are 91,734. Now, dear Goenkans, the exercise 2.3 given on page number 20 math side book also contains the word problems. And we can solve these word problems using the same concept. A part and B part have been shown on your assignments. Please do C and D part of question number 1 yourself. Dear Goenkans, please don't forget that all the work should be done on your maths notebook. And please mention the exercise number on the top of your page. And write the question number and the part number only. Thank you.